Our panel, Fox News political contributor Tammy Bruce. She's also Independent Women's Voice President. Shaw Galani, Capital Wave Forecast Editor. Danielle McLaughlin, liberal commentator. Danielle, you're the attorney on this. Before we talk about the trade deal, potential trade deal, apparently this goes back to the Nixon administration, and it was reaffirmed during the Clinton administration, yet we hadn't heard much about this until today.
No, we certainly hadn't heard anything about this from the Mueller team. So you're absolutely right. OLC guidance, which goes back into the 60s, says that a sitting president cannot be indicted because it unconstitutionally interferes with the duties of a president. So that being said, it's interesting that Mueller's team has said this. I'm not that surprised that they've come out with this because Mueller is a very by-the-book kind of a person. This may be challenged in court. OLC guideline is not Supreme Court precedent. We're just going to have to wait and see what happens.
Tammy, what are your thoughts?
Well, I think this is something that, of course, Mueller would have known. It's not a surprise to anyone on that team. And so as he's been proceeding, and if he's been looking and targeting the president or people around the president, but especially the president himself, it means that Mueller knows that this would just be a report. But then if it's a report, you give it to Congress. And that means he's looking for impeachment. So for everyone who is saying that this has been a target to remove the president from office, in a way, with Mueller admitting this, that this confirms that concern, because that would be the only trajectory for this kind of a report.
You know, it's unfortunate this didn't come out during the market. It would have been great, Shaw, to see how the market reacts to it. Again, to Tammy's point, Giuliani saying all they get to do is write a report. Mm-hmm. That seems a little bit more benign than the sort of things that we were hearing about, including a possible indictment.
I think it's time for this investigation to wrap up. Really, I thought Mueller was barking up the wrong tree from the get-go. He's gone further and further out on this tree. Now he's chasing falling leaves. I don't think there's anything that leads to any collusion with the president and the Russians whatsoever. It's time to wrap this up.
Real quick, Danielle, it's never been tested in court. You think Mueller would have the appetite to try to make history here?
He's just said that he doesn't, so I'm not sure that he will. No, I don't
think. All right,
think he will.
Let's talk about history, by the way. Tomorrow the talks begin, right? They get down, they get really strong. China, U.S., a trade deal. The vice chairman of China in town today in Washington, D.C., he said he was optimistic, Tammy, about a deal. I think, you know, all the signs point that both sides do want to get something resolved.
Yes, absolutely. And for China, I think what the surprise was that Donald Trump was a serious person. Because before, all they had was American media to determine who was going to be the next president. Hillary was a known entity, and they'd be able to roll over her like a monster truck. And then here was this guy who maybe people thought wasn't serious, and then they found out he was. I think they're also expecting a deal because China clearly has got to be helping with North Korea. So there's already been decision making when it comes to the nature of who's going to be getting what. This little current upset with North Korea is interesting. They did cancel, I believe, a smaller meeting summit with South Korea. That will be the extent of it. China's clearly told North Korea to deal, and that means there will be a trade deal and an agreement here between us and China.
A lot made yesterday about President Trump reversing his thoughts on ZTE, but I think perhaps an even bigger olive branch is Peter Navarro reportedly will not be in these talks tomorrow. Now, Peter Navarro has pushed this issue like nobody else in America for a decade. In fact, he's got books called Death by China, Crouching Tiger, The Coming China Wars, Blood and Nukes for Oil China, The Coming China Trade and Economic Wars, China and Weapons of Mass Destruction, The New Heart of Darkness, and What's Chinese this? Counterfeiting and Piracy.
No one can figure Navarro out. What do you think?
I think, you know, listen, I say congratulations to Peter Navarro for putting this front and center. But to me, him not being at this meeting actually means a deal. Probably they are, both sides are really serious about getting something done.
No, I think that's very true. And as to Tammy's great point, we need China to make sure that we get a deal with North Korea. We need all of those allies, frenemies maybe, in that region to make sure that we can constrain North Korea in a very, very important and hopefully historic way. Navarro out of the scene, I think, will help smooth and calm the waters, and hopefully they can get the deal done.
Shaw, for the markets, what would a deal mean?
It would mean an awful lot. I think the Mueller discussion that we just talked about is going to mean a lot for the markets tomorrow, and I think a deal will be huge for the markets because the markets are really just a little bit apprehensive about a deal not happening, about some trade war with China and that extending itself out through the Asia-Pacific region.
Let's be honest. The market doesn't really care about the composition of a deal, just that this is one issue off the table, a massive issue, because these big names like Caterpillar and Boeing, their profits are propelled by foreign markets, especially China.
It's the rhetoric that's bothering the markets, and the rhetoric is boiled over to the point where now we're getting to the negotiating table, and I don't think it's going to be anything that's going to be unsettling to the markets. It's going to be smooth, and the markets truly should take another leg up from here.
All right. Thank you all very much.